I don't know what mine is. That's something. Welcome back to my Tenchi 62 Elite Walkthrough. Alright then. Everyone there. And then level 83. Necessary. And now.
Do not give up your search. This is all a nightmare.
Do you seek my help?
This is all a
nightmare. Need another sword armor.
This is all a nightmare.
You're back.
This is all a nightmare.
I spent enough time running.
I am sorry about your friend's revenue.
I have no idea. He had a long. He lived. If he lived long enough, would you have influence as he might just taste in your hand?
You had a part to play in this struggle, and I was able to foresee that. Celia has known me for most of her life. She trusts me, and so she did as I requested.
I thank you then. Dude, how did you know I would know to just cleanse the entire isle of its vast
population? Meloniman, though I may not have known you personally for very long, I can see inside your heart. I suspect you know as well as I that it would not have happened.
teleport us here.
Another of the circles. What insights will this one hold? It is hard to believe that I am going to see this place with my own eyes at long last. This is the eye of sight.
What kind of sight?
An inner sight. It is hard to put into words. It is as if I can see past the realm of the physical and into the realm of truth. By the Agalans, I must tell you what I am seeing in you.
Yes, tell me that.
I see the blood that flows like fire in your veins. And then when I look upon my hands, I see the same.
You see into your body?
No. I mean, you and I, we are both from the tribe of Ajunai. I can see that now. It is for this reason I stayed my hand when I spied you at the jungle beach. I could not shoot you, and now I know why. We are kin.
Kin? I must think on this.
How's this all possible? You're a different race.
It is not our skin that matters. It is the bloodline we share. In fact, Lothar, we are brothers also.
I have Ajunai blood, you say?
We all do. All of us here.
That's hard to believe.
I speak the truth, Lothar. We are brothers.
dare you?
belt? Who enters my cave?
It's me, Lothar, in search of a thief.
Excuse me?
Don't lie to me. You stole a golden cloak from an elf years ago. I know because I've been accused of the crime, but it wasn't me, was it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're lying to my face. There's the golden cloak right there.
Well, maybe you're right, but no one will ever know.
I found you once, and I'll find you again if you run now. I, Lothar, swear it.
You can't escape.
Yes, you idiot. I told you I'd find you, and you made it easy for me with that key you left behind.
Curses!
Curse, yeah.
It's not enough to give me the cloak. You're coming with me, and you're going to confess your crime.
Never! I will kill you instead! To whatever you want.
Therefore, then we will be done. Even with one side machine. First, let's go left.
Thank you.
side mission.
Something bad has happened. I can feel it.
I do not believe.
You will see soon enough.
We must hope for the best.
And prepare ourselves for the worst. Valdis is more powerful than you realize.
What do you say this?
Because they are true. I only ask you to open your eyes and gird yourself for the battle ahead, Meloniman.
Let's wait.
Hold fast your sword. Have mercy. It has already been taken. I do not have it. Please, let me die in peace. I tell you, I do not have it. You are too late. It is gone. They have it. There was nothing to be done. It was filthy Vikesh that came out of nowhere, broke the caravan, took the Aegis to their outpost ahead. What? Who's there?
Islander, are you all right? Speak to me.
Princess Evangeline?
Yes, I'm here. I only wish I had been here when the caravan was attacked. Tell me what happened.
Oh, Your Highness, I'm glad you are not here, or they might have captured you.
Who did this?
Dark Elves, Vikesh, and Milady, I am sorry. They took Jessic and the soldiers.
No!
They said they would fetch a fine ransom if they did not kill them first.
Heads will roll. Tell me which way they went.
Into their forest. Something about a stronghold deep inside their territory.
I will find them. And those so-called Dark Elves had best take good care of my friends.
I think we had best find them before this.
Excellent. Another adventure. Are you prepared to kill those Dark Elves?
Oh, yes. Very much so.
I will be by your side. To the death.
Dare not to enter these grounds, for a mighty curse befouls the air and makes a mockery of faith and trust. A thrice-born curse which turns truth upon its head. One that finds life in broken vows and death in trusted hands. If you value virtue, heed my warning and come no closer.
Are you faith, Master Lever's servant?
No use if I for that name any longer. Once upon a time I answered to it, when it carried honor and trust. But now it is soiled in treachery. Murderer is the name I've been given. Return from whence you came and add no further to my torment.
Please, that you are innocent.
Innocent, you say? None were wholly innocent in that day. My name has been slandered falsely. I am not at fault for the crime of which I was condemned.
I am here to help you clear your name.
Dare I hope against hope? If your purpose is truly to return honor to my name, then I will open this door to you. But be warned, this place holds more than curses to contend with. Perils of flesh and bone wander these halls as well.
I will be on my ground.
I am doomed to roam these halls eternally, forever faced with a scene of a hideous crime.
Can you tell me what really happened?
Alas, I cannot. My knowledge of the events is incomplete.
The report of the time in the town when the god says you were found with your master's body and covered in his blood. Surely you remember this. And how are we going to be?
What the god saw is true. Yes, I wore my master's blood, but only because I tried to staunch its flow.
Why did you not get help?
Time was not in my master's favor.
Was he already dead when we found him?
That was my fear, but I could not be certain.
You are not being very helpful.
You say you wish to claim my name? Precious smack of accusation! I've told you what I witnessed, that I happened upon my master after he'd been savagely attacked. I tried in vain to help him, and as I did, one of the estate guards burst in and took me prisoner. Lady Levereth, upon returning home from visiting family, listened to the guard's report and called for my execution. My words to my own defense were in vain.
If she had worked for her family for years, why would she not give you the benefit of the doubt?
My lady was quick to anger and quicker to draw conclusions. You can see her portrait on the wall there. Go, take it. Master Levereth choked that her red hair was a warning against her temper. She was all a shell of a woman after his death. Though she could not see me, I walked beside her as she packed her things and left the estate. The information I've already given you. I can offer no more. You're free to search these rooms for whatever clues as may be left.
Second
time since I've seen this.
Whose hair is this?
No one of importance. Not any longer.
Vesture. The dainty. Dainty. Wow. Is this a lock of hair from a lady?
It is. Master Leverett liked to have it near him. The way soldiers carry a loved one's favor into battle.
But Lady Leverett's hair is red, not blood. Like this.
Aye. This was not from her head.
Master and Lady Levereth
never daughter. No. Lady Levereth was never able to bless the master with a child.
I see. A mistress then.
At last. The truth is out. Yes, the master had a mistress, and I helped him hide that fact. But know that I kept my master's confidence to the last.
For failing to revive the father,
I saw help. But I soon remembered the lock of Eric kept near. Its discovery would befoul his name. I returned to the room and sought the lock for safekeeping. But the guard accosted me before it could be found.
What about the item you were accused of stealing? Reporter assumed you were searching the room for valuables to take.
Nothing was stolen. There were items Lady Levereth could not find when she searched, but they were not stolen. Master Levereth had given them to his mistress.
Ready now.
They are still in the possession of the mistress.
Why would Master Levereth give such valuables to his mistress?
Alas, the mistress was with child. It was Master Levereth's intent to offer enough wealth to raise the child with ease in any town or province she chose, as long as it was not this one. At least the world will know that I was not a thief, even if Master Levereth's murder goes unsolved.
Is it possible Lady Levereth knew about the mistress? And the lady's temper brought to her to kill the master for it?
I do not see how that is possible. Lady Levereth was gone that day, visiting family. I put her in the carriage myself. And in the time following my execution, I heard the driver confirm her travel. Now, the lady did not murder her husband, though she knew about the mistress. In the days following my master's murder, she found and burned a love letter from the master to his mistress. I managed to save it from the flames once her back was turned. I thought perhaps, if someone were ever to find it, it might help lead to the truth. It is still hidden in the ashes of a fireplace. Day. I was not merely accused wrongly, I was wantonly murdered, and my master killed by cruel chance.
Why have you not read this before?
I cannot read. As a servant, such was above my station, and Master Levereth trusted me because of it. I could carry messages between him and the mistress when needed, and he had no concern that I would understand what was written.
Where is the mistress?
Dead. With my master. The mistress's chamber remains as it was. I did not tell you of her murder earlier because a part of me feared that my master held some blame in this. I found them together in her chambers. I moved him to his own chambers to protect his name. That is how I became covered in blood. But now I know the truth. There's still one thing for you to do. The letter may show the blame of the murder, and I will give you access to the jewels to prove no theft took place. Between the two, my name may be cleared. Follow.
Thank you.
between these items, I can prove that Uncle Thraneth was neither a murderer nor a thief. Now perhaps the curse can be lifted and my uncle can rest in peace. Please, take this for your efforts. It's the least I can do for you who have brought a ray of light back into my family's life.
Troubled. Aye. It's an ill thing to know just how deeply one has been betrayed.
More troubled? Indeed, the truth is disturbing, but why could he not find rest? There must still be something needing to be done to lift the curse. He is innocent, and we can prove that now. I must think on this. But you deserve a reward for your help. Here.
How can I rest? Knowing that the true culprits have not been brought to justice. You've done much to help me. How can I ask more from you?
Nonsense. I helped you this far. You see it through to the end. What do you need me to do, friend?
Lady Levereth returned to Arialan after her husband's death. She lives there still. As for her brother, I had not even known she had one. I cannot offer any information on him. But if you bring her to justice, surely she will know where to find him.
Very well. I'll return to Ireland and find her.
Friend,
ninety.
I would like to be alone, if you do not mind.
It might be hard to have lost your husband.
Yes, it is. Do I know you?
No, but we share a common acquaintance. I don't know when we are married.
The nephew of the man that murdered my husband? Why are you dredging up my painful past?
Eldoriath never believed his uncle was guilty.
It is understandable that the nephew would defend him, but the evidence was clear. Thraneth, our servant, killed my husband when he discovered the affair my husband was having.
You couldn't have been very happy with your husband.
Of course not. But I loved him. Please, stranger, I really do not want to talk about this.
He did have us. I do not believe Thraneth killed your husband. I think you had him killed.
How dare you? What is this rubbish? Be gone, and leave me in my sorrow.
Perhaps you did this, but you are also guilty. I found the jewels. Really, you are wicked.
I did not want to do it.
I was so angry with him. It was my brother who convinced me that it was the best thing. He arranged the whole thing, and it was his hand that slit my husband's throat.
Your brother? And who is he?
Guardian Commander of Amalu.
What? Guardian Commander Vephyr is a murderer? Elder most trusted advisor? I must warn him.
Lady Levereth! Come with me, please. Warden Celia will want to hear of this. Now.
Very well. Strange name. It is a relief to have this finally brought into the light. Oh, my husband. Forgive me.
Greetings. Celebhel has his hands full dealing with the attack on Amalu. So if you really must speak with him, make it quick.
Actually, you are the one with the woman I have with.
What can I do for you then?
I come for Iron. Can you guess who I met there?
Irulan. I cannot say that I know anyone from that backwater town.
Familiar. Wetherall, was that not the one whose husband was murdered by his own manservant? She is your sister?
Indeed, and she had an interesting tale to tell. Since our Wetherall is much more than a simple guardian commander.
You do not know what you are talking about, foolish child. Now be gone. We have important matters to attend to.
I don't think so, Wetherall. I've been you proof of Bretry's cries. It was he, not really Wilmarin, rumor of the Master Levereth. He then conspired with Lady Levereth to frame Freddy Wilmarin. Whoever faith the seal who kept the Master's secrets. Moving by new statue around his name.
What? Wetherall, explain yourself immediately.
Filthy rat. How dare you speak of such matters here? You who have served Valdis as faithfully as I, and now you have the nerve to call me out? I should have delivered that useless relic correctly to his hands myself once I knew how eager he was to have it. You will pay for this, arrogant pup.
Not so. You stare in the face of justice, Wetherall.
Die!
I cannot believe that it was Wetherill who betrayed us. He has been the very image of truth and justice in Amanu for years. It was he who informed Valdis of our ages. Ah, an ill blow indeed.
Some people will go to terrible life, cheap art.
And at such an inopportune time, you deserve commendation for your courage in this. You have prevented further damage for the interests of the elves, and for that, I am most grateful. Take this, then, as a symbol of my debt to you, Malonamon.
You've done more than I ever thought possible. In the light of Istara, I bless you. Now, the far shores across the Blessed Waters are no longer shrouded in fog. The light, the white cliffs are shining. Farewell, Malonamon. I go last to my peace.
Silver Towers, Renny Filmer, let me see Dragon Elf Gim. Alright. Subscribe to my channel to put my better next time. Good night.